How are you?
I'm great. Can you hear me?
Dr. Nathan Sneddon is an MD of interventional spine and pain management. His office started using telemedicine about 4 months ago when COVID-19 really hit. It's not for every doctor's visit.
Particularly in my new patient evals, I need to see patients face to face. I need to examine patients with my hands, my ears, my eyes, and especially my hands. You can't do that via telemedicine. And for those new patients who you've never seen, never met, you really can't substitute it with telemedicine.
But it's excellent for follow-up visits and certain kinds of ailments.
I think maybe a dermatologist who can usually examine just by eyesight for the most part. I hope I'm not wrong in saying that. I'm not a dermatologist. But generally those kinds of specialties where a patient can be evaluated primarily by sight and sound would be okay.
Administrators at Bingham Memorial Hospital have telemedicine available for every specialty. In the last 4 months, the hospital has booked 5,800 appointments. Skipping the office visit has lowered the exposure to infection from other sick people in the waiting room.
The patient has a lot of responsibility too when it comes to making telemedicine work. So when you have your appointment, make sure you're in a quiet corner, that the doors are closed so the dogs or the kids can't come in and make noise. Have all your prescriptions out so if the doctor has any questions, you'll have them handy. Make sure that you have a tablet so you can write down any questions that you have before the meeting and then any instructions that the doctor gives to you.
Dr. Sneddon says insurance used to refuse to cover telemedicine appointments, but that's all changing because of COVID-19. Most appointments last about 15 minutes, and it is proving to be a real lifesaver for rural areas that are hours away from a specialist.
And just have you reschedule another